Okay, so Onshape is just a web-based version of SolidWorks. So in SolidWorks, you can do all of the same things you can do in Onshape and more. But the ability to manipulate it in a browser is really nice.
Very nice.
So, I mean, all of these parts I just modeled while I was sitting in class. But you can see, so, you know, every part by itself is separate. These parts that are gray are actually imported. So I can import from existing models, standard content. So I have like, you know, I want a bolt of this size and this shape, then I can import those, or I can search other public domains for other types of parts.
Oh.
So you don't have to model everything by yourself. So I pulled in the Omni wheels and the caster wheels that way. But anyways, it's just, it's really nice to be able to model things like this.
So how do you move things around in it? Just create, maybe do a new one and just create something really simple. Like, let's just create a box.
Okay, here, let me just go into a new file then. Hang on. Step here. We'll go personal projects.
Was that the shifter that you built?
Yeah. Yep.
So it's a new document.
What do you want me to build?
Well, just, I don't know, a box.
Okay. Okay, so what I'd do is I'd pick the plane that I wanted to draw on. So I'm going to draw a sketch, and that's just going to be the drawing for one face of the box, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so it's saying right here, okay, I'm drawing on this top plane, right? Mm-hmm. It's sketch number one. I can rename it if I want. So I'm going to click the top plane, so I'm just viewing that. So gotcha. It's like I'm looking down on a piece of paper.
Gotcha.
All I'm going to do is I'm going to pick a rectangle, and I'm going to go out as big as I want it. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So let's just say that that's what I wanted. Now, the thing that you're going to want to pay attention to is these are arbitrary dimensions, right? So I have to actually go to this. That's just a fact of modeling, right? And decide what I want for my size. So I just decided that that's going to be 5 inches.
Okay.
And then I'm going to say this is 5 inches. That makes it a square. Okay, we're done with this sketch.
Okay.
Okay, so now you can see we just have a drawing on that plane.
Mm-hmm, of the top.
Yep. So after the sketch button, you see all these buttons right here are different options of what you can do with a sketch. Now, some of these are more complex than others, but if you hover over any of them, it gives you a description of what it is.
Gotcha.
So if I want a box, I'm just going to extrude it. And you'd know that you'd pick extrude if you hovered over it. You could read the description.
Mm-hmm.
I click what I want to extrude, and I want it to go...
Extrude meaning you're just adding depth.
Yep, you're just pulling it out.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to add... Why is my mouse not clicking? 5. Okay, so now this is a perfect cube. Okay, I hit enter, and I've got a box. Now if I wanted to hollow it, right, because this right now is just a solid block. If we were to look inside of it, where's my... There it is, section view. Okay, so with this button, I can actually look inside it. See? So I can see it's one big solid square, right?
Yep.
Okay, so... I'm going to get out of section view. And
so now these, what are these planes on the bottom?
So these are your X, Y, and Z axis. So those are the three planes that you can draw from. Now, if you want to get more complicated, you could create planes in any direction you wanted.
Right, but those are the common.
Yeah. So I've got a square. So after you use these ones to create a shape from your sketch, then you use these to detail the shape.
Now, the front is right in the middle of that box. Can you move it?
So, I could move the box, but
it doesn't really matter.
It doesn't affect anything.
Gotcha.
These are like stencils almost, like they're just floating there for reference.
Okay.
But your datum is your center point right here, right?
Okay.
And that's where all three planes meet together.
Gotcha.
That's your center point. And the reason that this is halfway through the box is because... You look from this angle, from where our center point was, where we drew the rectangle,
yep.
That runs exactly. Right through the middle. Yep.
Okay, that makes sense.
So, after you create a shape with these ones, then you move to these ones, and these actually allow you to detail that shape.
Yep.
So we're going to pick shell, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And I don't want to really remove any faces. I'm just going to hollow it. But if I wanted to, I could actually remove any face so you could look inside the box. So now the box is hollow, and there's a thickness of 0.1 inches on this shell.
Of around the box walls.
Yep, so I'm going to show you right now. So we'll turn this section view back on.
And
now you can see
that it's hollow.
Yep, so you've got a solid surface right there. That's that 0.1 inches. And then the rest of it is just an empty box.
And I know that because I can see the planes.
You would see the planes no matter what.
Oh, okay.
So the planes are just referenced. The only reason you know it's hollow is because you pick this function, shell, which means it creates a shell of it.
Where's that function again?
So it's this one right here.
Oh, okay.
So these are the ones that detail what you want to do with your box after you've made it. So you draw the picture, you make the box here,
mm-hmm.
and then you detail it here.
Okay.
So say I wanted to round my edges, okay? I want this, this, this. This is more aesthetics than anything, right? But say I just keep going like this. I pick those edges. Boom. Now all the edges are rounded.
Nice.
And I could pick, you know, whatever tolerance I want. I wanted it circular, but I could do it in a different type of edge too, right? Like it's going mm-hmm. thinner and thicker to one point, right? That's called a variable fillet. So if I change this to 0.5, oops, I broke it. Let's go 0.3. That's still upset? Fine. I'll do 0.2.
Mm.
But if you change it, you change how much rounding there is. See how
got
the 0.1?
Mm-hmm. Now, put a circle inside the box.
What do you mean?
Put a circular image inside the hollow box.
Like, do you want me to make a hole that's
yeah, let's
a
do this. Pop one of the sides of the box off and put a circular thing inside of it.
Like a different part, a different shape. Is
mm-hmm.
that what you're saying?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So,
yeah, it'd have to be a different shape, right?
Yeah, that would be the easiest way to
a
do
ball,
it.
A ball, right? A ball.
Yep.
So take a side off and then put a ball in the middle of it.
Okay. So you got a side is gone. Okay.
So how did you do that?
So I
can
just...
you hit, does Control Z work?
Uh-huh. Yeah, so thank goodness it does because I'd be in big trouble if it didn't.
Okay.
So I just clicked shell because I already had that command in there, right? But I just want to change how it's doing the shell.
Mm-hmm.
So I had clicked hollow here because that's all we wanted.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to unclick it, and now it says faces to remove.
Mm-hmm.
So it wants me to click which sides I want to take off.
Mm-hmm.
I can do multiple sides.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm going to click this one,
oh.
and it does the shell, and it takes that side off. Now if I wanted to do this one as well, boop.
Very
so
nice.
Now it just leaves what's left, right? So I'm going to put the top back on.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so now we've got that. So in order to do a separate part, you're going to have to do another sketch.
Mm-hmm.
Right? How do I want to do that? Oh, there's a really good way to do that. Do I want to... I'm trying to make this the easiest for you.
Mm-hmm.
Because I could do it inside... Okay, so let me back up for a second. So if you look down here, there's a part studio and assembly. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
It's intuitive of what those are, right? This is a part... and we built the part.
Mm-hmm.
You can take it and put it inside of an assembly. Okay, so insert from my current document. I want this part in here. Boop.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's inside there, right?
So you're assembling something together.
Right. Because we're making a separate part, it would be the easiest practice to create
a new one.
A
can
new
you
part.
Save, but that box, do you save it to a library?
It's already saved. So because it's all, it's like a Google Drive.
Okay.
So it's auto-saving as we're doing it.
So when you go under assembly, your box is going to be there.
Yep. Oh, I see what you're saying.
Did you identify it as a box?
So these two are linked. So I pull this, and basically all this is saying is find this part and source whatever version is in that part.
Okay.
So they're interlinked. And
but
so
you can save them as specific names too, right?
Uh-huh.
As
yeah.
your own components.
Yep. And
okay.
just like code where you can like... You know with like Git how you can pull
mm-hmm.
branches and
mm-hmm.
commit branches and you have a master copy? You can do the same thing here.
Oh, okay.
So if I'm working, one of the great things about Onshape is that you can do it with multiple people on this, at the same time, working on the same assembly.
Oh, that's nice.
So like, okay, so in our second part studio here, we'll just do, we're going to pick a sketch and we're going to pick a plane. It really doesn't matter what plane you pick. I just picked top because I wanted to, but we'll do front this time.
Okay.
Just to show you it's universal. Okay, so all I want is, what is it in 2D, right? It's just a circle, I mean a ball
right.
is just a circle.
Right.
I'm going to put that at, let's see, we've got a 5-inch box. Let's do a 3-inch diameter.
Okay.
Okay, so we'll say that's good. So we've got our circle.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, fine. Okay. So there's this thing sometimes that happens where when you do a revolve,
yeah,
if you have a whole shape and then you're trying to rotate it 360, it runs into itself.
Oh, I guess that makes sense.
Yeah. And so what you do is you make it half of a circle. And then when you hit revolve, you pick that revolve axis right around the circle. Boom. That's right. So now we've got this ball.
Yep.
Okay. So we're going to go back to our assembly. We're going to bring the ball into the assembly. So we've got ball part number two. We can put it right there. And now
you got a ball. Perfect.
In the middle of your...
And then we follow the same process to build anything.
Mm-hmm. So you have to imagine every aspect of the device or the piece or the model from a two-dimensional perspective.
I wanted to create something that's a rectangle that has a concave in it.
Mm-hmm.
That's a different concave.
Yeah.
I'd get all of the distances, and then if it started here and if the concave went like this, I would know every measurement along the way as it's dipping in, basically. What I'm looking for,
I've
really
got something
is
for you.
Like a door, like, you know, when you put your hand on the inside of a car and you open up your door, there's a piece of plastic that goes into the door itself. The door handle's here, but there's a concave, you know, that sits there so you put your fingers in and open. You know, just like when you just left the car.
Yeah, it's part of the door.
It's part of the door.
Right.
Right, but it's like a concave that goes inside.
That's super easy. So watch. So all I do, I'm going to pick the front one this time.
Yeah.
Actually, I'm going to do this instead. Hang on. Because I'm not going to make more work for myself than I need. Whoa, what just happened to my bar? There it is. I'm going to duplicate this first one. So I'm making a copy of my box.
Okay.
Okay, so now I've got a second box.
Yep.
And instead of taking the shell, I'm getting rid of the shell, and I'm getting rid of the fillet. Now it's a solid square again.
Okay.
Okay. Now I can just take these dimensions, and let's just say I'm going to make this 10, and I'm going to go up to, just to use, give us a surface.
Right.
Let's go 7.
So we're building the insert that goes into the door.
Yep. So
piece of plastic that goes into
what we're going to do, how far do I want that to go? Okay. So we're going to build it on this plane right here. So see this plane right here I'm looking at?
Yep.
This is the front one again. But I'm looking at the bottom of the square.
Right.
It's not really relevant which side. You just have to stay consistent with whatever side you're using. Okay?
I gotcha. Okay.
So I'm going to do a second sketch in the same part, because we're still modifying the same part.
Oh, okay. So you can do multiple sketches in the same...
Yeah.
Okay.
The reason we did them separately is because those function as separate parts, and you want them to fit together.
Right.
Whereas this one, we're taking one shape and
modifying it.
So it's still the same part. Does that make sense?
Yep.
Okay, so we are now drawing another sketch. Yeah. Okay, so we're going to do a circle, and we're going to do that circle way up here. Now, do you see why?
Yeah, because you're just going to dip into it.
Yep, so what we'll do
is... It's going to consume the space, basically.
You just, instead of adding to it, like you'd be adding a ball to it,
you're subtracting from it. Yeah.
Exactly. So because we learned our lesson last time with circles, we're going to make sure to cut this one in half.
Yeah.
Okay. And then we're going to trim this. Doop. And see how this is blue?
Yep.
And this is black?
Yep.
The reason for that, I didn't mention this, is that this is fully dimensioned, meaning if I were to try to drag it, it's not moving anywhere. This one's blue, which means the computer has not been told that that's exactly the size it's going to be. There's some dimension that can still move.
Oh, I got you.
So, watch. I can click it.
Right.
right? Which sometimes you want.
Right.
Right? But let's just say that's what we wanted. So then if we want to lock that in place, we click here. Okay. We'll say 5. Okay. Now
we have to go back to that other tool to make it a circle, right?
Yep. So we're going to revolve around. What is this button on the side I keep clicking? I don't even know what that is.
Oops. Windows, I think.
Okay. Now, instead of, see how it says add? That would add this to this.
Yep.
We're going to say remove. Now, that's a crude estimation.
No, no, no.
Right.
Right, I got it.
I could do a, what's it called, an ellipse, and I could actually do it more precise, right? The idea with modeling is you start with the rough idea, and then you fine-tune it.
Yep.
Right, but this is the concept.
Okay, so when you export that.
Yep.
Do you export it or print it?
You export it. So you right-click, you hit export, and this is where you have to know what file compatibilities you have with your printing software, because there's different software.
Yep.
So the one that's usually pretty good.
But it covers most of them, right?
Uh-huh. Yeah, this is all the generic file.
Okay,
types.
So mine covers the generic.
Yeah, so STL is a pretty solid one.
I think that's one of them that this one is. What are the other options?
An STP you could also use, or an IGS, but IGS I'd probably steer away from the most.
Okay. The, I think mine supports STL and STG.
STP?
B.
Yep.
Okay.
So what you're looking at is how it's looking at this whole thing as an infinite amount of points.
Right.
And it's tessellating it in different ways. So IGS and STEP are going to take more of a point tessellation based on relativism. So I've got this point and this point, those make my frame, and there's a relative amount of points in between that. So it's not the actual body of it. It's just a wire of it, right?
Right.
And STL is designed for printing, so it's stereo something lithography. And that is for contours and shapes and printing.
Oh, okay. And same thing as STP?
STP is a wireframe, but it still matches all the dimensions you need for printing. All
right.
So, but I would usually stay with STL for printing. So, but see how there's a SolidWorks one too?
Yep.
So I just export it as a SolidWorks part if I'm working with SolidWorks, and then they can import it into their software. It's compatible.
But they could import an STL as well.
You lose different amounts of maneuverability with different file types.
Right.
Because it's a wireframe, for example, you could see the shape of it, but you couldn't manipulate it.
Right.
It's been exported as that shape, so you can't change that. So, anyways.
And that's it. So you export it, and then you just bring it to the print driver.
Yep, that's it.
And then it prints exactly as that.
Yep.
That's awesome, Nick.
So
I'm going to have to sign up for an account.
Sounds good. So the thing...
They did stop on that recorder. Would you see it on the right there?
Yeah.